I often poke fun at Earth for not being a perfect planet, nor orbiting a perfect sun, nor being located in a perfect galaxy, and all of those things are true. There are very likely better worlds in this universe for life than this one, but perhaps more likely there are many worlds that are worse than Earth, and while they may allow intelligence to arise, they may not allow it to do anything other than live in a primitive state. More, Earth may end up being one of those worlds. This is the concept of reset and can take many forms, both self-induced or through natural disasters of a magnitude greater than we can currently handle, such as a coronal mass ejection pointed directly at us. See my video on the Carrington event in the end screen. But that's still something we can mitigate or control if we put in the effort, as is the notion of deflecting asteroids that might impact Earth. These are things within our current technological grasp to protect ourselves against. But what if something that is not? What if natural disasters of a kind that it will be centuries, if not longer, before we can do anything about? Thankfully, Earth doesn't have too many of these, but it does have one glaring one. That would be a supervolcano eruption. Earth is a volcanically active planet and always has been. This favored life, and in fact may have played a role in life's genesis here, but volcanoes are a double-edged sword in that they can affect very wide areas depending on what type of eruption is occurring. Scale that up, and entire continents can be essentially destroyed, with global atmospheric effects that could completely reset our civilization, if not cause our extinction. Earth has had many supervolcanic eruptions, one of which may have affected us directly. Humans are not particularly genetically diverse, at least in some ways, compared to other species, and it's always been an open question as to why that is. It may just be the nature of our genetics, but one somewhat controversial hypothesis is that our population bottlenecked about 70,000 years ago due to environmental changes that were brought about by the eruption of the Toba supervolcano. In other words, it's a scenario where almost everyone died, and we descend from the handful of survivors. While contentious and difficult to prove, the Toba bottleneck begs a question: could this happen again? The answer is yes, and at some point, it very likely will happen. Worse, new research suggests that these kinds of eruptions happen more frequently on Earth than was previously thought. They are very hard to predict on geologic timescales, but the current guess is that they happen about once every 17,000 years, and there are current powder kegs, such as the Yellowstone supervolcano. At the same time, the chances of you being alive during one of these eruptions is very low, and such a thing may not result in our wholesale extinction. We've apparently survived them in the past. But what if that cadence were more frequent? What if an alien civilization is subject to a supervolcano reset every few thousand years? In such a case, it seems likely that they would never leave their version of the Stone Age, kept frozen at a low level of civilization forever by the volcanism of their world. Or perhaps they would have just enough time to get into space. Imagine a scenario where you don't just want to leave your planet out of curiosity and desire to explore the universe, but rather you live on a ticking time bomb and you must get out while you can. Imagine if that happens to us. Thanks for listening. I am futurist and science fiction author John Michael Godier, and if you would like to help support the channel, check out my Patreon page, link below, or check out my books at your favorite online book retailer and subscribe to my channel for regular in-depth explorations into the interesting, weird, and unknown aspects of this amazing universe in which we live.